Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to teach you how to hire a virtual assistant. For those of you that don't know, a virtual assistant, otherwise known as a VA, is a remote employee. One of the advantages to hiring a VA is that you can hire them from anywhere in the world, including developing countries that have a lower cost of living, which means that the salaries are lower than countries like the United States. And when I say much lower, I mean $3 an hour lower. And while it may sound scary hiring employees, it's really not intimidating at all. In fact, it's the key to making your businesses passive. As I described in my video, the four ways to make passive income online, and I've got a link to that video in the video description below. I've got several VAs that work with me, and if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be able to run my businesses or scale them, so I very much appreciate the work that they do. I've already discussed how VAs are a great solution for handling dropship fulfillment, but I've also used VAs in the past to help me with website design and product research. In this video, I'm going to be answering two key questions. One, what websites should you use when hiring virtual assistants, and how do you use them? And two, what countries should you hire in, and which countries should you avoid, and which ones are the cheapest? I think some of the answers here may surprise you. All right, let's jump straight into it. Question, which website should you use to hire virtual assistants? There is no steadfast, easy answer here. There are lots of websites that you could use. In this video, I'm going to be showing you my favorite ones to use. The first is Upwork. Upwork has a huge user base, so you'll have a lot of applicants to select from that have a lot of skills. Plus, it's very safe and easy to use as an employer. Posting a job is easy and free. Just come and click Post Job. Next, you can select what type of job you are posting. When hiring a VA, I recommend that you start with fixed-term contracts. This isn't just for your benefit. It is for the benefit of both of you. This way, you can see if you both like working together. If you both like working together, then you can talk about moving to a permanent, ongoing position. If you've got a previous job, you can reuse that. Otherwise, select a category. Next, type in a title for your job description. Make sure it is very detailed. Next, type in your description. Again, the more descriptive, the better. You can add attachments. I will often add videos that capture my computer screen and show exactly what I need completed. This is, of course, optional. Next, select how many freelancers you want to hire. When you are new to hiring VAs, I recommend hiring just one and getting used to having an employee before you hire any more. Next, select the type of project. Again, I recommend having a fixed term project and then moving to a permanent one from there. Next, select how you want to pay. For fixed jobs, you'll usually have to pay a fixed price. If you're hiring someone ongoing, you'll pay them by the hour. Next, select what level of experience you want. Now here is where most business owners fall into the trap. They select entry level. This is a huge mistake. Someone who is entry level won't have the experience, so you don't know how reliable they will be. Businesses live and die by the talent of their employees. Never take them for granted. I almost always select intermediate or expert. Don't worry about their hourly rates listed. Those are for USA-based freelancers and VAs. Next, select how long you expect the job to last. Since it's a fixed-term contract, it's probably going to be between 1 to 4 weeks. Next, select the time commitment. For this section, I strongly suggest that you select that only freelancers on Upwork can find the job. The reason for this is that you don't want your competitors finding your job postings, which they can if you select it so that the search engines can find your listings. Next, you can add preferred qualifications. I don't usually bother though, because it doesn't stop anyone from applying for your job. Next, you can add some screening questions. I strongly recommend that you add some so that you can see if people answer them in their application. If they don't answer them, then they didn't read your application and you can immediately reject it. Next, you can require that they add a cover letter. Cover letters are helpful when deciding between applicants, so I do require it. Once you've finished this, click Post Job, and then you are done. When it comes to hiring people, the process is also very streamlined and beginner-friendly. In your dashboard for the job posting, you'll see a list of the different applicants for a job, including their proposals. You can then click on each proposal. you'll be able to see what their job history is, including their reviews. Scroll down and you'll be able to read their cover letter. Usually, these are just stock cover letters. That is absolutely fine, as most people I know offline and online will reuse a cover letter. If you scroll down, then you'll see their work history and feedback if they have any. Scroll down further and you'll be able to see their portfolio if they have one. There is a test section. Upwork provides different tests that VAs can take to prove that they have certain skills, such as a language proficiency test. There is also an optional section in their portfolio for employment history. And there is an optional section for their education history. Quite likely, you're going to want to message candidates that you've shortlisted. And once you've selected the candidate that you want to hire, the hiring process is also very simple. On their application, click Hire Freelancer. Here, you'll need to fill out the application. If you want to modify the budget based on your negotiations with them, you can do so here. Next, you'll need to deposit the money that you've negotiated into an escrow. If it's a one-off job, you can also split the money into milestones. For example, this job is about analyzing 3,000 products. Together, we may have negotiated that half of the money will be released when half the job is finished, and then the other half when the job is completed. If the job is ongoing, then Upwork will automatically pay the VA for you using the credit card you provide. You can modify the description of the project and contract here. Otherwise, by default, it will populate this field with the job description you originally posted. Agree to the terms of service and then click Hire, and you are done. A word of caution with Upwork. While Upwork may be good for the people hiring the VAs, Upwork is not very good for the VAs themselves. This is because for the first $500, Upwork is going to charge them, the VA, 20% in fees. Not to you, the VA. So if the contract is for $100, then Upwork is going to charge them $20 in fees, which is huge. Between $500 and $10,000, Upwork is still going to charge 10% in fees, which is a lot. What this means then is that good VAs quickly come to dislike Upwork and they avoid the platform. So in the future, while it's kind of against Upwork's rules to take the contracts off of the website, I suggest that you do so. In addition to Upwork, I also use another website called OnlineJobs.ph. This website is exclusively for hiring virtual assistants located in the Philippines. Upwork actually has a really strict policy against country discrimination. You can't come on there and say that you only want to hire someone in the USA or that you only want to hire someone in the Philippines. So if you are interested in hiring someone exclusively in the Philippines, then OnlineJobs.ph is a great site to do that. Beware, it is not free. It kind of looks free on the outside because with a free account, you are able to post jobs on the website. But without a paid plan, you can't reply to applicants that message you or even read the messages. Plus, it will take 2 days for your application to be approved. With their lowest cost plan, your job postings will be approved instantly. Personally, if I'm looking to hire a VA based in the Philippines, I will use OnlineJobs.ph instead of Upwork. Every time I'm looking for a new VA for my business, I will upgrade to their lowest cost $49 a month plan, find my VA, and then cancel my membership. So basically, every time I want to hire someone new, I upgrade, get my employee, and then immediately cancel. Part of the reason why, though, that I use OnlineJobs.ph is because, as I said earlier, on Upwork, the best VAs often leave the website because it's actually a really bad deal for them. And the best VAs in the Philippines will often end up on this website because if you hire someone through this site, then you handle the contracts privately. I personally pay all of my VAs with PayPal. There is no escrow system. Posting a job is simple. Simply click Post Job. Next, add a title to your listing. Next, add a job description. Here, type in the payment. I recommend either writing it in USD or in PHP. Again, I recommend that when first hiring that you used a fixed term contract, so write a fixed price here. Next, select the type of employment. For a fixed term contract, you should select freelancer. Next, you can select to require an ID proof score. Good candidates will almost always have a high ID score, so I usually select this to be 70. Next, select the skills you require. I always require written and verbal English skills. Why? Well, because even if the job doesn't directly use them, it's important that I can communicate with them. Next, type in your email address. And then you are done. You can then post your job. Now, as I said, the process of hiring on OnlineJobs.ph is very different to Upwork. At Upwork, there is a whole process for shortlisting candidates and then creating contracts and then using an escrow system to hold payments to ensure that both parties have their payment managed. But again, it comes at the cost of very high fees. But OnlineJobsph is very different. On here, people send you messages which go into your inbox. Unlike Upwork, which includes their work history and education history in their original application, here you'll only receive their actual message. It's a lot more informal. Unlike Upwork, applicants are allowed to include their alternate contact details like their email address and Skype in the application. On Upwork, this is considered circumventing and it is against their policies. You can click through to their profile and find out more information about them, such as a link to their portfolio, their ID score, any tests they've taken and the results they've achieved, and a self-assessment of their skill set. It's up to you to email each applicant back, negotiate a contract, and then handle it privately. I've got a link to OnlineJobs.ph in the video description below. Please be aware that is an affiliate link. Here at Wholesale Ted, all of our videos are free and affiliate links help keep our videos free. Question 2, which country should I hire my virtual assistants from? Honestly, there is no steadfast rule here. You could hire a virtual assistant from anywhere in the world, and that is the beauty of it. If you are hiring a virtual assistant from an Anglo-European country, like the United States, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, UK, remember the cost of living in those countries is very high, so expect to pay high prices. If you're looking to hire a VA in a country with a lower cost of living, then the most common ones to hire from are India, Sri Lanka, Pakistan, and the Philippines. The median salary in India is $620 a month. The median salary in the Philippines is $570 a month. The median salary in Pakistan is $480 a month. And the median salary in Sri Lanka is $400 a month. Again, there is no country that is better than the other. However, I personally hire most of my virtual assistants from the Philippines, and this is for two reasons. One, the Philippines time zone is closer to the New Zealand time zone. It's only 5 hours behind, so usually my workday will overlap with my VAs based in the Philippines. It can be quite frustrating when your time zones don't match up. For example, I have a great web guy, but he is based in the Ukraine. So unfortunately, he's usually online when I'm asleep, which means then that it can slow down projects. Depending on where you live, your time zone may match up better with, say, somebody based in India. Secondly, in the Philippines, there is a strong fluency in English. It isn't the first language, but it's kind of the second. That is because in the Philippines, English is a mandatory subject in school. Now, please don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that English is the best language at all. It's simply the language that I personally know. So if I want to be able to communicate with my VAs, then we need to be able to not have that language barrier. Because of this, when you're looking at applicants across multiple countries, you're going to find that there's going to be a higher density of applicants in the Philippines that are fluent in English compared to other countries, which makes the vetting process a lot easier. But again, this is no steadfast rule. You might have an applicant based in Sri Lanka who is highly skilled and perfect for the job. But for me, the time zone issue means it sways it greatly in the direction of looking for VAs based in the Philippines first, so that is my preference. Alright guys, I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, I'd appreciate it if you gave it a thumbs up and subscribe to us here at Wholesale Ted for more great videos on online selling.